Hey guys, I welcome everyone to News in Shots. This is a special session where we cover some important news in a very short and crisp manner. This session is brought to you by Anshum Verma. I'm a practicing advocate. Plus, I have a teaching experience of mentoring UPSC aspirants from past 10 years. The topic for today's discussion is a very important space mission. In fact, it was a very important lunar mission which was launched by Russia. And we just received this information 2 hours ago that this mission has crashed. You can link this topic with GS3 space. So guys, Luna 25 is one of the most ambitious mission of Russia to launch a vehicle or to land a mission on moon almost after 50 years. However, very sadly, this mission got crashed onto the moon, and this incident has happened just before the landing, or when this Luna 25 was carrying out the pre-landing maneuvers. That means it was reducing its orbit and it was approaching closer to the moon, and then the Roscosmos, the Russian space agency, has lost the connection, and then it got crash landed into the moon. So as per the reports, Roscosmos has lost connection on Saturday itself at 2:57 p.m. That means yesterday. So earlier there were news coming up that Luna 25 has experienced some glitches, and these glitches has, you know, transformed into a complete failure of this mission. So according to the preliminary findings, the lander has ceased to exist following a collision with the moon. That means they have lost a complete connection with their lander. So it is an abnormal situation that has occurred on August 20, which when it was, you know, preparing to transfer to its pre-landing orbit, or you can say it this way, when this Luna 25 was reducing its orbital discourse. So during this operation, is pure operation mein, an abnormal situation has occurred on the board with the automatic station, now which did not allow the maneuver to be performed with the specific parameters. So there were some scientific glitches that has happened, because of which the soft landing has impacted, and then Roscosmos lost the connection, and it resulted in a crash landing on the moon. So right now, there are much more details which are yet to come. Okay, we'll look into those details, and I will make a special separate video related to what was the exact reason. So a little information about this Luna 25, guys. This Luna 25 has been launched on 11th August with Soyuz 2.1 rocket. Now this is the most advanced launching rocket that Russia uses. It has been taken off or blasted off from Vostochny Cosmodrome, which is somewhere around 5,550 kilometers east of Moscow. So the lander has boosted out of the Earth's orbit towards the moon. A little over an hour later, it enters the moon's orbit in August 16. Now guys, if you compare this Luna 25 with our Chandrayaan 3, both the mission were, you know, they were competing against each other to reach on the moon, and their landing sites are almost similar. So what will be the implication of the failure of this mission for Russia? Now guys, when Russia Russia is such a country that is into these space exploration from, you know, the beginning of the Cold War. They are fighting a space race, just like what they are having a defense race or an arms race on the land. They are also having a space race with all major powers in the world, especially USA, China, and India. For India, you can say that it is a partner-like situation, but still, it is a competitor. So, it underscores and it has declined Russia's space power and its glory. Why? Because Russia is the first country that has launched the first satellite in space, Sputnik 1, in 1957. They were the first one to launch any satellite in the space. You can see Sputnik 1 here. And then Russian cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin became the first man to travel into the space in 1961. So all these achievements has, you know, kept Russia at a very high standard when it comes to the space research. And then there, the attempt on a lunar mission has been planned after a very long time. You can say, to be precise, it is after 47 years that Russia has launched a lunar mission, because the last mission was launched under the presidentship of Leonid Brezhnev. This is the guy who once used to rule Kremlin, Russia, and it was then the last mission was launched. So Luna 25 was supposed to execute a soft landing in the south pole of the moon, and the expected date of this landing was 21st of August. So we all know that it is also competing with our own space mission, that is Chandrayaan 3. By the way, a detailed video on Luna 25 I have already made. You can check it from the playlist attached in the description box. So Russia is racing with this Chandrayaan 3, and our Chandrayaan 3 is expected to be, you know, it will land on 23rd August, and in the evening it will land somewhere around 6 p.m. This is what the timing that we are right now getting. So I have added a little comparison of both the missions. Like Indian Chandrayaan mission has been launched on July 14, and it is expected to reach moon on August 23rd, because Indian Chandrayaan, you can think it this way, that we were following our own self-controlled trajectories. Like Indian Chandrayaan 3 was first, it has, you know, increased its orbit and it has slowly come out of your Earth orbit or the Earth's gravitational pull, and then it has entered the lunar transfer trajectory orbit. However, this has been done by Luna 25 in just one attempt, and they have very swiftly shifted their trajectory. Now, if you say how it is possible that Russia can do this, not India, was again unsuccessful. Again, guys, there are various reasons. Like Luna 25 is a much bigger mission with a good number of payloads and much advanced technology. The budget of Luna 25 is almost, you know, multiple times, like I guess it is five times more than what the Chandrayaan 3 is. Then if you can compare the payloads, the total weight of Chandrayaan 3 is 3900 kilograms, whereas Luna 25 weighs around 1750 kgs only. So it is much lighter. The shifting of the trajectory is much easier for Luna 25. Then if you compare the landing site of both the missions, they are very close to each other. And the mission life, our Chandrayaan 3 is expected to work in one lunar day. One lunar day is around 14 days of Earth Earth days, whereas Luna 25 is expected to work for 1 year. Both of them were planned, they were planned, their location were planned at South Pole. Their main objective is to detect water and other resources, and then also to study Moon for the future space explorations. Future space exploration. So these are some basic objectives of both the missions. One more unique feature about, or you can say a comparison between Chandrayaan 3 and Luna 25, is that Chandrayaan 3 is an orbiter, lander, as well as a rover, whereas your Luna 25 is just an orbiter and a lander. That means there is no rover inside Luna 25. And that is why you can again compare that why your Luna 25 is much lighter. It is because of these reasons. So both of them will be collecting the samples and they will sharing the data back on the Earth. However, the scope of Luna 25 sending any signals is almost over because it has finally crashed into the Moon. By the way, till now, only 3 countries have made it successful soft landing in the dark side of the Moon. It includes Russia, it includes USA, and guys, it includes China. Even China has launched their mission in the dark side of the Moon. They are also successful. Like their Chang'e 4 mission was the first mission that has been successfully landed on the dark side of the Moon. Then guys, what are the reasons for this crash? What do you think are the reasons? So many experts are saying this, that Russian economy is facing sanctions from quite a long now. It has been way too long that Russian economy is struggling with all those sanctions. So the import and export for high-tech technologies have become difficult. And then Russia entering war with Ukraine. Like when I was covering Luna 25, I have discussed this in detail, that because of this Russia-Ukraine war, there were earlier components which has to be supplied by European Space Agency to Russia. But because Russia entered the war, the French and the European Space Agencies have taken their hand back and they didn't supply those equipments. So they are lacking behind the high-end technology equipments, and then they are, you know, relying on their own self-indigenous production and research. However, when it comes to the technical research like space, at times you require, not everything you can, you know, build it on your own. There are some expertise that you have to borrow it from the other countries. So over the period of time, because of this, you will see that Russia has faced many such crashes in the past. Like one more crash that I can quote you, in 2011, the Phobos Grunt mission, which is one of the moons of the Mars, underscores the challenges of facing Russia's space program. Like Russia was planning to launch a mission on the Mars moon in 2011. However, this mission failed because again, the launch was not that successful. So eventually, in early 2010s, Russia has settled upon the idea of launching a Luna 25, which finally have crashed. However, they have their future missions ready, which are again for Moon only, Luna 26 and Luna 27. Both of these missions are expected to be launched in next 3 years. So guys, very soon, our Chandrayaan 3 will also be making a successful landing on the moon, but let's hope for the best. We are crossing our finger because landing on the soft side of the moon is in itself is a challenge. Okay, you can understand it with this, like we refer to the south pole of the moon as the dark side of the moon. It gets very difficult for all the scientists to, you know, maintain a regular connection or maintain a regular connect there. So hoping for the best, I hope you enjoyed the content given in this video. Do hit a like button and share this video with your friends. Also, if you're planning to take a UPSC comprehensive subscription for the upcoming UPSC exam in 24, you can use this code Shrirams for a holistic coverage of your UPSC syllabus. Everything will be covered under one subscription. You just have to use this code Shrirams, S-R-I-R-A-M-S. So thank you very much. See you in the next video.